What's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be using the one, the only, the Blunderbuss, and I'm actually using the royalty variant. I was lucky enough to get this thing out of an advanced supply drop. If you happen to miss that opening, I'll put a link down below in the description so you guys can check it out. But wow, this thing is majestic. And we're going to talk a little bit about this weapon. We're not going to go too in-depth on the statistics or anything like that, but there are specific things that I want to talk about and let you guys take a look at the gameplay. Tomorrow we're going to cover the STG-44, and then the next day we're going to take a look at the SVO, because that sniper rifle with the iron sight is completely ridiculous, so prepare yourselves for that. So the Blunderbuss, in general, is a shotgun. It is also a shotgun that is loaded and primed with black powder. You also put the little balls in there, the little pellets in there, and the reload animation just takes a long time. As you can clearly see, it just takes a very long time. Now, this is not necessarily a bad thing. This thing can do ridiculous damage up close, and one of the coolest things about this weapon is you can actually still put on an advanced rifling to increase your overall range. One of the other cool things with this weapon, I keep just listing off really good things about it, is it has more pellets than the Bulldog or any other shotgun in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, so you're more likely to get one-shot kills the closer you are, of course. You will see a lot of hit markers, and if you do see a hit marker, you can basically guarantee you're going to die. It's only because the reload is so long. I haven't found myself getting a double kill with this thing yet. I think it's very possible in hardcore, which I'll be testing in a couple of days, but this thing is awesome. I love it just because of the way it looks. I love it because it has that old-timey, old-school feel, and the fact that you can get into a battle with someone else that has this thing, or if someone picks it up off the ground, makes it extra interesting, just because if one person misses and gets a hit marker, or if you miss your shot completely, the other has a chance to swoop in and get that kill, all while making sure something else is going on in the background, so you really have to make sure that you are aware of your surroundings. I found it more useful in maps that have tight quarters, like this one in particular, Horizon. There's a lot of corners where I can sit back and reload really quick, where I can get my grounds, where I can get my health back, and then move in for the quick kill. A lot of times, I found myself just aiming down sight rather than hip firing. I don't know why. I felt personally like a placebo effect that it helped a little bit. I'm not sure if this actually does. You cannot get a laser sight on this, and that's the only shotgun you can't get a laser sight on, which is very interesting, but you can get the quick draw handle, and it definitely does help if aiming down sights on somebody that's directly in front of you. Otherwise, you can just consider yourself gone because of that reload animation. The one thing that I thought of to possibly help with that is running the perk Fast Hands, and that's something that I never really do unless I'm running a secondary weapon, just so I could swap a little bit faster. But Fast Hands will actually allow you to reload while sprinting, so if you happen to get into a tight situation where there's multiple enemies and you know that you're not going to be able to blast them both to get a double kill, you're going to be able to run away and reload while doing that. So if you need to get around a corner really fast, or if you need to dash forward and then get around a corner before reloading, you can do that all while sprinting and you'll be good to go. So when that enemy finally does come around the corner, hopefully you have everything ready to go, and hopefully you didn't sprint cancel if you weren't using Fast Hands. And that's something that I found myself doing quite too often with this weapon. For those of you that may be unaware or just don't know, I call it sprint cancel. Sometimes you can just call it reload cancel or whatever. If you sprint without Fast Hands during a reload, it will cancel out the reload and you will just sprint without doing whatever you were doing. If you cancel your sprint or you cancel the reload at the right time, you will cut the reload animation down, being able to raise your weapon up faster and engage in battle a little bit quicker. With this particular weapon, I found myself canceling a little bit too early without actually adding all of the stuff and dying completely in my tracks. So that's one thing that I'm still trying to figure out here. As for stuff that I can say improve on, the only thing I really could say improve on is the reload animation. Maybe make it a little bit faster, but to be completely fair, I think it's as fast as it's possibly going to get. With that high damage profile and the fact that it does have a little bit of range on it, you're still able to get a lot of kills in quick succession rather quickly with this weapon. So I just wanted to show it off for you guys today. I wanted to talk a little bit about it. Maybe I'll do an elite weapons video with this royalty variation. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you missed the supply drop opening, I will put a link down below in the description so you can check it out. I got a lot of awesome legendary stuff and at least one variant of all of the new weapons. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure to click the thumbs up button down below and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.